Are you worried about your students cheating on their writing tests with all this new AI-generated text? Well, this video is for you. Recently, there's been an explosion of tools online that can produce pretty passable AI-generated text, and it's got a lot of teachers worried that the next time they're asked the students to do a written test or piece of homework, instead of doing it themselves, they're going to visit one of these websites like ChatGPT and just ask it to do it for them. And I'm wondering, how can we as teachers detect this text? So in this video, I'm going to show you two ways that we can detect and identify AI-generated text. And the last one is so easy, you're going to wonder why you didn't think of it before. So before I show you the first idea, it's important to explain that the current model that's being used to generate language, such as ChatGPT, is based on a model called GPT-3. And before that, there was GPT-2, which is an earlier model. Now, obviously, GPT-3 is a lot more advanced and can produce more reliable results, but there is a detector online that can identify text that's produced with the GPT-2 model. So all we need to do is visit the website Hugging Face. I'll put the link on the screen right now. And it has an output detector for GPT-2. And if we use GPT-3 text in this detector, it will identify it as fake. Now let's imagine that I set my students a piece of homework on an essay, and the essay was titled, How Lord of the Rings is a Reflection of Our Society. My students input that prompt or that title into ChatGPT, they copy it from there and they send it to me, and I'm reading it and thinking, this looks very good for this student. So I copy and paste this entire text and I pop it into the output detector website, and it's fake. I've got you. So we've seen that it's detected a response from ChatGPT as fake. And let's go take a look at hopefully a piece of more authentic text online in this film review. And so we take this film review and we pop it into the same detector website, and lo and behold, it's identified it as real. But I know what you're thinking. What if that student takes that initial text from ChatGPT and just changes it a little bit and then submits it as their homework? Well, if we go to a website like Quillbot, which actually has a rephrasing or paraphrasing function, then let's take the first paragraph of that essay that was written by ChatGPT and pop it into Quillbot to rephrase it. So now that Quillbot has rephrased it so it reads differently, let's put it back into the output detector website to see if it still detects it as fake. So we put it into the box and it's still fake. Although the percentage has dropped a little bit, we can still see that the detector was still able to identify it as fake. If you'd like your students to become more autonomous writers, then I made a video right here which gives students some ideas on how to use other tools online to help improve the level of their text. The second way to detect AI-generated text is really simple, is to go and ask ChatGPT itself. Now, this AI is very honest, too honest for its own good. So all you need to do is write the prompt, did you write this? And then take the essay and copy and paste it in full. You press enter on ChatGPT and it will tell you, yes, I did write that. Well, that's a good trait to have for an AI system. But before we finish, let's see if we rephrase that text and pop it into ChatGPT and ask it again if it wrote it. So we take it into Quillbot, for example, rephrase it a little bit, put it back into ChatGPT and ask them, did you write this? And yes, it's still able to identify it as their own text that they produced. If you are a teacher and you're looking for some positive ways to use this tool in your classroom, then I made a video right here where I go into four ideas on how to use ChatGPT in the classroom. So there you have two ways that you as a teacher can detect any AI-generated text in your students' work. Now, it's not completely foolproof, but it's a start. And I'm sure that now, teachers, you can relax a little bit knowing that there are options online that can help you identify this. I'll see you in the next video.